This week marks the 30th anniversary of the Americans with Disabilities Act, a groundbreaking law that prohibits discrimination based on disability. The legislation has been invaluable for what it changed, but significant obstacles still exist for those who have physical or mental impairments of any kind. When President George H.W. Bush signed the law in 1990, it guaranteed new protections for work, education, access, and transportation, among other rights. Many of the physical accommodations that are now commonplace only came to pass after the ADA became law. In fact, as seen in the Netflix documentary Crip Camp, it took longer to guarantee these basic civil rights than it did for other groups, including Black Americans, Latinos, and Asians. And a generation of advocates took to the streets to demonstrate and protest through the 1970s and 80s. But even after all this time, the challenges for people with disabilities remain enormous. Just 32% of working-age Americans with disabilities have a job. People with disabilities also live in poverty at more than twice the rate of people without disabilities. We're going to explore these questions more in a moment. But first, the NewsHour spoke with a number of Americans and asked them to reflect on what it means to live with a disability today.
My name is Brittany Wilson. I'm from Brooklyn, New York. I'm a disabled civil rights attorney. I have cerebral palsy.
Hi, my name is Bill Krebs. I live in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. I'm a person with a disability myself. You may not know it. It's a hidden disability.
My name is Elizabeth Bostick. I am first and foremost the proud parent and humble servant of King James. He has a rare disease called connectorus, which is caused by severe jaundice at birth.
I'm Jen Dierenwater. I'm a citizen of the Cherokee Nation of Oklahoma. I'm also bisexual, two-spirit, and I am multiply disabled with chronic illnesses.
My name is Alice Wong, and I'm a disabled activist in San Francisco.
My name is Max Barrows. I am a person on the autism spectrum. I speak up for people with disabilities throughout the state.
I think it's safe to say that my life wouldn't be anything that it is right now because the ADA literally gave me my rights as a disabled person. The fact that I was able to attend law school and receive accommodations and to be employed as an attorney. But I think also as a civil rights lawyer in particular, I know the limitations of the law. That's what the ADA is. At the end of the day, it's just a statute. It gave us the bare minimum, which is our rights. And rights are not anything if they're not enforceable.
Well, before that, the ADA, kids like myself were segregated in school. We didn't have no education. We were never heard, never seen, never did anything. Employment was the hardest thing for people with disabilities. We were placed in shelter workshop programs where we just sat there and did nothing. We did some minimum wage jobs. We made a whole dollar. Well, I was there for 10 years of my life. I thought as a person with a disability, I would go nowhere. So I started being a self-advocate.
When I think about ADA, you know, the key word for me is access. And that coupled with a number of other disability laws really gave everyone the ability to have access to whatever tools were necessary, any reasonable accommodations were necessary to be able to live as independently as possible. And so as his mother, of course, one of my primary concerns is, can he effectively communicate his wants, his needs, his desires, to live the life that he wants to live and to be in charge of it. And so a lot of technology has been built as a result of that because there was a demand for it.
You know, one of the caveats of the ADA was to try to stop the institutionalization of disabled people. Well, that's not really ended. Like, yes, we do have more options, but disabled people are being institutionalized all the time. I can't tell you the number of times I've had medical providers or, you know, healthcare workers try to put me in a nursing home. I don't need to be in a nursing home. Just make sure I have a disability accessible apartment and a home health aid, and I can mostly get by on my own.
I do think, especially with the pandemic, my rights out here and to be protected from discrimination is really important. I am legit worried about coming down with COVID-19 and not being a priority or considered a life worth saving, that these attitudes will not be fixed by a law. These are vulgar, more difficult cultural changes that need to happen. And that takes time.
We're still not seen as independent or productive people in many areas because we rarely are given the opportunity to prove ourselves. And people should let us be in the driver's seat of making decisions for ourselves. And who knows us better than we know ourselves?